Hi, this is Carlos Licea, and we are at the library at Santa Barbara High School. And we are talking to Dennis O'Leary, who's going to tell us about the history of Chilean Nobel Prize winning poet Gabriela Mistral, who lived here, across the street from this building. Hola, este es Carlos Licea, y estamos en la biblioteca del High School de Santa Barbara. Y aquí nos va a hablar Dennis O'Leary sobre la poetisa Gabriela Mistral, que ganó el Premio Nobel de Literatura en 1945, que vivió precisamente en el otro lado de la calle de esta escuela. Ok, Dennis, ¿nos puedes hablar sobre Gabriela, por favor?
Sí. Pues a mí me interesaba mucho saber más de la Gabriela Mistral, una poeta y maestra destacada, incluso la primera latina de ganar cualquier forma de premio Nobel, y ella la ganó en literatura en el año 1945. Chilena, pero ella vivía en muchas partes del mundo. Y yo recuerdo de haber leído una vez, cuando yo estuve estudiando en Santiago de Chile, que ella una vez vivía en Santa Bárbara. Años después, casi 30 años después, me toqué hacer la pregunta, ¿en dónde vivía aquí en Santa Bárbara? Y me sorprendía que nadie sabía. Entonces, esa fue la meta, a encontrar dónde vivía Gabriel Mistral aquí en Santa Bárbara. Y nos costó unos años de ser detectives y la encontramos aquí al frente del High School de Santa Bárbara. Justamente, incluso a ese lado de la escuela, es un jardín infantil que es muy importante si uno sabe de la historia de la Gabriela Mistral. Y aquí estamos al frente de un azulejo que hicieron en homenaje de Gabriela Mistral aquí en la biblioteca, con uno de los poemas de ella, para que los estudiantes puedan fijar en que alguien de América Latina destacada no solo vivía aquí, pero ya sabemos que ahora que incluso enseñó aquí en esa escuela a una vez. Entonces aquí está la placa.
Okay. Now, can you tell us that in English too, for the audience who does not know about Gabriela Mistral?
Sure. We're here in the Santa Barbara Library at the high school, and Gabriela Mistral is a very renowned poet, Chilean. She was also a teacher, and in her travels, she not only became famous as an educator, but she was the first Latina to win a Nobel Prize, in her case in literature, for her poems. And as a student myself in Santiago, Chile, many years ago, I remember reading a reference that she once lived in Santa Barbara, California. Many years later, I asked the question, where? Where was the house that she lived at? And I was very surprised that nobody knew. So it took us on a detective search, and it took us a couple years, and we found out that she lived in front, across the street, from Santa Barbara High School here. And the journey was interesting, and the result was even more interesting, I believe. We'll get into that. But we're here at the library, and a tile had been put up in her homage to recognize that Gabriela Mistral not only was a very famous poet that lived here, but now we understand that she even taught at Santa Barbara High School for a time as well. And the joke is, if you have a Nobel Prize winner in literature living across the street from your school, you invite her to the classrooms to teach the kids. And she did. So this is a poem of Gabriela Mistral.
Con cenizas, con desgarros, con nuestra altiva impaciencia, con una honesta conciencia, con enfado, con sospecha, con activa certidumbre, pongo el pie en mi país.
y en lugar de sollozar, de moler mi pena al viento, abro el ojo y su mirar, y contengo el descontento. Vuelvo hermoso, vuelvo tierno, vuelvo con mi esperadura, vuelvo con mis armaduras, con mi espada, mi desvelo, mi tajante desconsuelo, mi presagio, mi dulzura. Vuelvo con mi amor espeso, vuelvo en alma y vuelvo en hueso, a encontrar la patria pura al fin del último beso. Sin pedir perdón ni olvido,
nunca el hombre está vencido, su derrota es siempre breve,
un estímulo que mueve
la vocación de su guerra.
Pues la raza que destierra
y la raza que recibe le dirán al fin que él vive, dolores de toda tierra.
Vuelvo tierno, vuelvo con mi esperadura, vuelvo con mis armaduras, con mi espada, mi desvelo, mi tajante desconsuelo, mi presagio, mi dulzura. Vuelvo con mi amor espeso, vuelvo en alma y vuelvo en hueso, a encontrar la patria pura al fin del último beso.
En lo que era el patio de la casa de la poetisa Gabriela Mistral, y encontrar este lugar fue una de esas investigaciones que logró hacer el señor O'Leary como un gran detective. As we stand in front of the place where the house where Gabriela Mistral lived, and our great Chilean Nobel Prize winner, finding this house was quite a detective work from Dennis O'Leary, who's going to tell us how he did it.
Yes, well, first, the simple fact that I knew that she lived in Santa Barbara, it's well said that she lived in Santa Barbara, but I started to ask where. And I started off by asking friends who live in Santa Barbara and have lived here for many years, and they didn't know. And so the next thing I did is I contacted the National Museum for Gabriela Mistral in Chile, and very sure that they would come up with an address. They didn't know either. They confirmed that she did live in Santa Barbara, but they didn't know where. It took a couple years, and on the internet today, you could probably find something like this much simpler, but the internet hadn't caught up to this just yet. What we did find eventually was the paperwork of the papers when she bought the house. And in fact, it took a time for that because we found out that she used her real name, not her pen name, Gabriel Mistral. She used a, ¿cómo se llama?
Vicuña.
No, su nombre.
Oh, Lucía Godoy de Alcayaga.
And that was the final moment when we knew that we had found the place, 729 Anamapu in Santa Barbara. When I found out, it was a Friday evening, and I remember that because the next morning, Saturday morning, very early, I came with my wife and my three children, who were very small at the time, and we stood right here, and I wanted to see what the house looked like because, you know, driving through especially the older sections of Santa Barbara, I always tried to imagine where she lived and tried to guess. And when we came here to find that it was right in front of Santa Barbara High School, and in fact, this side of the high school is a children's kindergarten and preschool, which is very appropriate for Gabriel Mistral, since she wrote children's poems as well. It's fantastic to look around and see that this peaceful place more than likely was an inspiration for her, but also a reward. She bought this property with the money that she earned from the Nobel Prize. So now, from here on, it is documented where she lived, and we're able to now build upon that. And even in Chile, I was surprised how it snowballed. This was kind of a personal thing. I wanted to find out where she lived. What happened was we had the Chilean government send a stone from her hometown in Vicuña, Chile, to Santa Barbara. In fact, that's we placed a plaque on that. We'll be visiting that shortly. But we almost had the Chilean president, Presidente Lagos, come for the dedication. He wasn't able to make it. We did get the ambassador from Chile, came from Washington, D.C., to attend the ceremony. And then the surprise was how impressed and how excited the Mexican government was. And I found out that in the 1920s, the teacher, Gabriel Mistral, was invited to Mexico City to help reform the educational system in Mexico. And not only is her poetry used in Mexican schools, but she helped shape free education for all in Mexico. And so this snowballed. And not only were we able to find a lot of information up until the point that now we know the address, but people from here on can now take that information and continue to find out more about this woman who is very mysterious. Not much is known about her outside of her poetry. So it was a labor of love, and it was a detective story that I was able to work with and show my children, my three boys, the process as well. It was a lot of fun.
Okay, good days. Now let's step over to the park and look at the plaque, and we'll hear more about Gabriela. De los niños en Santa Bárbara, y aquí es donde se ha puesto una placa en honor a Gabriela Mistral. Y el señor O'Leary fue uno de los que nos trajo este honor. Esta es una piedra que vino de Vicuña. Ahí tenemos a Villan, que nos va a recitar un poema de Gabriela Mistral.
Gabriela Mistral amaba mucho a los niños, y yo les voy a recitar un verso de uno de los poemas de ella. Los ríos son rondas de niños jugando a encontrarse en el mar. Las olas son rondas de niños jugando este mundo a abrazar, abrazar. Ahora Dennis lo va a hacer en inglés.
Rivers are children holding hands, playing and running to the sea, tugging. Waves are children holding hands, playing at greeting the world, hugging and hugging.
Pedimos desde el Parque de los Niños en Santa Bárbara, donde la música de la risa de los niños se oye, tal como Gabriela Mistral lo hubiera preferido. We're at the Children's Park in Santa Barbara, where we hear in the background the music of the laughter of the children, just the way Gabriela Mistral would have loved it, since her poetry dealt with children for so much. Reporting for the Octa Community Multimedia Center, Carlos Licea in Santa Barbara. Thank you.